How to make a paper plate weaving project. Part two. Our first step is to make 7 marks on your paper plate with a pencil. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You're going to cut your paper plate, making small slits with your scissors on top of those pencil marks. We're now going to make a mark at the bottom of your plate, directly in the center, and you can eyeball that. You're going to cut a small slit with your scissors. Now you're going to take your string and we're going to wrap it around around your plate. You'll take a small piece of tape and you're going to tape it to the back of your plate. And then now we begin wrapping. So you're going to go from here to here, 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 here to here. So it's going to go around once. And then you'll thread it through each slit, going from left to right. So wrap it around. Wrap around again. And again. And again. And one more time, and one more time after that. Then you'll cut your yarn and you're going to tie it to the existing piece of yarn that you started with. Now, I made several knots just because I had a lot of excess on the end. But how many knots you make doesn't really matter, just as long as it's secure and tidy. So that's how it looks from the back and the front. You're going to take your first color and you'll tie it to your first kind of rung there on your paper plate. So I've tied it once, made a knot, tied it again, and then now we're going to start threading. So I cut the desired length. And that's totally up to you. We're going to go under, over, under, over, under, over. And that's our first row. Now I'm going under, over, under, over, under, over, under. And that's your second row. Now under, over, under, over, under again. So you get the idea that you're going to be alternating. So you never want to go under, under, or over, over, right? You're always going under, over, under, over. And you just keep doing that all the way up until you have as many rows as you'd like with that one color. Now I'm using yarn that was previously dyed to have multiple colors in it. But we are not using that kind of thread today. We're using solid colored threads. And I will show you how we will switch colors. So let's say you have a green yarn and you want to change it to yellow. I'll show you how to do that in just a moment. Thank you. All right, so I'm coming to the end of my thread. So to change colors, you're going to tie the new color in a knot with your old color. And I double knotted it because I want to make sure that it's going to be strong. So I've got my knot, it's tied very tight, and then I'm going to use my scissors to cut off any excess yarn. And then you thread again. So then you start all over again, under, over, under, over. Rainbows are visions, but only illusions. And rainbows have nothing to hide. So we've been told, and some choose to believe it. I know they're wrong, wait and see. Someday we'll find it, the rainbow connection, the lovers, the dream. So we've come to the end of our rainbow. How do we finish it? You're going to tie a knot around your gray string. Don't be afraid to take your time with that. And I made a really tight knot, and then I cut it, and now you have an amazing rainbow weaving project. This is how it looks in the back, and here's what it looks like on the front. What's so